Schools are the second homes of the students, and the hero teachers serve as their second parents. The four corners of this second home witness the laughters, dreams, struggles, friendships, and precious moments of the young generations. This is the place where we learn how to write, read, count, color, draw, perform, and most importantly, this is the place where we develop ourselves holistically until we become somebody. This is a precious place. This is our second home.
No face-to-face classes.
Sobrang lungkot nga po namin nung nabalitaan namin wala nang face-to-face. Iniisip nga po namin kung paano na yung pag-aaral ng aming mga anak.
But no one could ever imagine that the place where we shared our precious moments has to close its doors and windows due to the pandemic crisis we are experiencing nowadays. In just a wink of an eye, everything changed. No one could ever imagine how this pandemic outbreak could change everything in a short period of time. It's between life and death, education and health, family and community, self and others. However, despite its negative impacts, this pandemic crisis opened doors and windows of opportunities to the Department of Education to mitigate the disruption of classes and continue providing quality education to the learners through the adoption of the relevant learning modalities, one of which is the use of modular distance learning. Every member of the educative process worked hand in hand to provide modules and other learning materials to assure that no pupil will be left behind. School heads, teachers wholeheartedly embraced the new normal work arrangement to reach out to every learner and parent. The parents patiently accepted the challenge to serve as the learning facilitators to their children. Indeed, a precious moment to cherish.
This is the new normal.
This is the reality. Along the way, we heard parents' sentiments and behind stories as they teach their children at home and have tried their best to educate their children, but they truly had hard times teaching complicated lessons. This is the reason behind the least learned skill in different subject areas.
Kinakaya naman po, sir. Kaya lang, may mga lesson kasi na mahirap ituro sa bata.
This challenge serves as an eye-opener to each and every one of us to do something. This marks the start of creating instructional video lessons to address the least learned skills in different subject areas. Applying what we have learned in the different webinars we have attended, we started creating lesson plans, scripts, shooting using our smartphones and green light, and video editing. We have video lessons in Filipino, mathematics, science, and music, and still preparing to create more to help our school children.
The parents and the learners can access these video lessons through our YouTube channel and Parents Messenger group chat. They enjoy watching it and will receive comments and feedbacks that their children learn a lot through these video lessons. Indeed, pupils' performance in these particular skills improve a lot.
Well, in creating these video lessons, we did not spend so much on the amount. We only use improvised matters and we teachers as living instructional materials.
This pandemic outbreak might contribute negative effects to the current Philippine educational landscape, particularly in terms of program delivery and student access to quality education.
But as the catalyst of change, we must work as one,
unite as one,
and be someone who has the power to turn negative situations into opportunities.
We are the teachers at the heart of education recovery.
This is the innovation of our humble school, Kabalutan Elementary School.